Hello, 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 hello. Hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. Hello. Welcome to another lore stream. We haven't done one of these since Sister Location. Was anybody here then? We haven't done one of these theory lore streams since Sister Location. And we're back again. And I have so many surprises to show you guys of the hidden screenshots, which possibly some of you guys have already seen, but some people haven't. Secret minigame. And I want to just talk about the lore as well, just the lore of this game. That's what I want to do. So yeah, as you can see, I've got my drawing pad here, so I can go like, I can draw and stuff like that without looking. And we can make some notes, just like we did last year. And this stream will go live, so if you missed the stream, you can go back onto it. But I will be making a video on this, what we've gathered today. So yeah, we'll get ready. Yeah, there's loads of things I want to talk about. I want to talk about the death screens. I want to talk about Funtime Chica. I want to talk about the minigame secret with the dirt pile. And I want to, like I said, I want to talk about the story as well. Just the full story about this game. What are we doing? Why are we interviewing animatronics? Why have we got a pizzeria? And the ending as well. Okay? So, yeah. Let's just start off with... what should we start off with? Should we start off with the looks of the animatronics? I think that's what we should do first. I think we should go with the looks of the animatronics. And what they look like. I've got the images of the animatronics in the best detail as possible. And I just wanted to discuss that first. Okay? So, we'll go with the... because there's no extras menu in this game, we can look ourselves, okay? So I'm going to get the images of the animatronics up. We're going to get Lefty, Molten Freddy, Scrap Baby, and Springtrap. We'll go with Molten Freddy first because that's the first image, the first animatronic that we have. So yeah, this is Molten Freddy, and this is what he looks like. And I'll be showing the death screens after this as well to, again, show you guys what they look like in full form, and it's huge, guys. So yeah, this is Molten Freddy, and as you can see, he looks interesting. Thank you for the super chat, Carly. The thing is, what people are debating is how they've managed to turn themselves into this. How have they made themselves turned into this? You know, it doesn't look like Funtime Freddy's mask. It's kind of like, it's not pink. It's not pink and glossy like Sister Location. I should actually get Funtime Freddy up from Sister Location as well. That would be good, wouldn't it? So you guys can see the comparison between the two. I think that would work better. Let me get Funtime Freddy up. If I've got a good image of him, that would be perfect. I should have a really good one somewhere because I've got the files of Sister Location. Here we go. Okay, I've got Funtime Freddy here. And it will be a lot more easier for you guys to see the comparison. You know, it's easier to explain then. And remember, guys, this is a live stream, not a video, so bear with me. I'll find a picture of Funtime Freddy. Should we? I want to explain this as well, by the way, guys. It's kind of obvious, but I'll go on to this and I'll show you the death screen of Funtime Freddy, and then you'll understand it even further. Just in case some of you are confused on Funtime Freddy. If I can find the image of him, that would be great. But the files are so big, it's hard to find one. I want a good image of Funtime Freddy. We don't need one of Ennard, really. You guys know what Ennard looks like. Just in case, I'll get one up in a sec. This one's fine. So as you can see, there's a huge difference between the masks. Absolute huge difference. You can see that the ears are not the same as well. Different sized ears. The cheeks are not there. It's a different colour as well. Funtimes Freddy's mouth is like an orangey colour. Maybe that's withered pink, like a faded pink colour. But it's definitely different, as you can see. And it's all broken up as well. The eyebrows look similar, to be honest. And he has his hat as well. Does he have the same hat, though? The hat has a purple stripe on that one. Let me see if I can find an image of Funtime Freddy showing the hat in detail. That's him just about to come up. And as you can see, it doesn't have, by the looks of it, we can't really see because it's a bit blurry, but I don't see the purple stripe on the hat, which again is very interesting. And I want to talk about this in a minute. Yes, it could be rust as well. You're right. Unless Scott didn't want to show the purple stripe. I don't know. Maybe he forgot. But I don't see a purple stripe on the hat. And I just want to talk about this in a sec. Okay. So are you guys ready to see the death screen of Funtime Freddy? Because this is going to blow your mind if you haven't seen it yet. I hope you have. He's burnt. We don't know that yet, whether the sister location animatronics were in a fire or not. It's not confirmed. But I'm going to show you guys the death screen of Funtime Freddy. So prepare, guys. This is big if you haven't seen it. This can appear at random times when you die in sister location. This is Funtime Freddy's mask. But as you can see Ennard's wires and Ennard from sister location. This is in the game. This is what happens if you die randomly. You sometimes get this screen. Funtime Freddy's mask. Next to the trash pile. As Molten Freddy. And you can see Ennard's eyes. All the wires on the floor with the mask. It's Ennard. Molten Freddy is Ennard. Molten Freddy is Ennard from sister location. It's not in the sewers, guys. I'll go into more about this in a minute. It's actually next to the trash pile in the back alley. You'll see more of these death screens at the same location in a back alley with trash cans and trash piles. You can see, guys, the eyes. You can see Funtime Foxy's. You can see a Funtime Freddy's eye there, the blue one. And you can see other eyes here. This is Ennard. This is Ennard. Ennard has four spirits in. And I'm not saying five, and you'll understand why in a second. The reason why there's only four spirits in here, because if you remember a while ago, Scott did something in the source code on his website where there was a conversation between Baby and Funtime Freddy and the rest of Ennard. Baby got removed from Ennard, and that's why Baby is a single entity in Five Nights at Freddy's 6. Funtime Freddy has took over Ennard and is now in control of the animatronic because Baby has now been kicked out and Funtime Freddy's took the lead role as Molten Freddy. Still though, with the other three spirits. That's why at the end cutscene, when Henry speaks to the animatronics, says that there's more spirits in Ennard. Because it's Ennard. The four other spirits are inside of Ennard. Baby got kicked out and then turned into Scrap Baby. Again, I'm going to show you guys Scrap Baby in a sec with the death screen. It's interesting, right? We'll talk about more of this later. I don't want to compile everything just yet and go make you guys confused. Interesting, right? Anyway, let's move on to what we're talking about, baby. Let's talk about Scrap Baby. Let me get an image of the beauty. We'll get an image of Baby, and I'll show you guys the comparison between the two again, I think. So this is Baby in sister location. And again, guys, you know there's a huge difference between them anyway, but it's always nice to show the comparisons. Always. It's always good to. And this is Baby. This is the new Baby. As you can see, they're similar but different. Okay, they got she's got wired hair, really weird hair. She's still got green eyes and stuff. As you can see, sharp teeth, different face, withered, different dress, different endoskeleton and stuff like that. So yeah, they're very much different. And again, guys, we'll explain why in a second, because I've got a nice little theory why they're all different and they've all got different designs and stuff. Because Scott wouldn't change the designs without a reason, right? But yeah, as you can see, there's a huge difference between the two. I'm going to show you guys Baby's death screen now. So prepare your butts. Because this is, if you haven't seen this, guys, it's, again, interesting. And again, I've got an explanation for it. So don't worry. It's fine. I've got this all explained. Well, my ideas anyway. You guys are more than welcome to have different ideas. Of course you are. Are you ready, guys? This is Baby's death screen. I'm going to brighten it up to show you guys the details. Whoa, that's not what I wanted to do. That's a bit spooky. I sharpened the image. I was supposed to brighten it. I thought I could brighten it on here. I think I can only sharpen it. Right, okay, I'll do it on Photoshop. 2 seconds. Can't brighten up the image. Sorry for wrecking the surprise, guys. I'll open it up on Photoshop for you guys, and I'll brighten it up on there. So it's better. So you guys can see it better. Okay. It's complicated, guys, because I'm on a drawing pad, so it's like all over the place. Let's go about here. Yeah. Then we'll brighten this baby up. There we go. There's actually a better image of this floating around, so I'll get the better image. I'll actually get the better image now so you guys see it better. Hold on. But yeah, you can see, guys, it's insane, right? As you can see, Baby is in possibly the same position as where Enid was. It's in the trash pile. I think these pictures are before the interviews. So, you know when Henry's on the recording and he says, this was found in the back alley? These images show this is the back alley. This is where the animatronics were placed. For us to grab. It's crazy, right? Still makes no sense to me, though. Why these animatronics have been placed in this back alley? Where have they come from? And why do they look so different? Because as you can see, yes, you're right. She's got rollerblades on, guys. She's got roller skates. She has got roller skates. No joke. She's wearing roller skates. You can see here. Right here. She's got roller skates on. Here are the wheels. Roller skates. Crazy, right? So it's a completely different baby. And her hair, again, her hair's completely different. She's creepy. She's got sharp teeth. Why have they got sharp teeth? Teeth? Why have they got sharp teeth for? Like, I honestly believe that something happened after FNAF 3 and before FNAF 6. And again, I'm going to go into this more later. That's my thoughts. I honestly feel like something happened in between FNAF 3 and FNAF 6 to make the animatronics look like this. Maybe the freak show. Maybe there was another horror attraction where these animatronics were bought and then they changed and then something happened there and they've been abandoned at this alleyway and then Henry picks them up and then we get rid of them. Something like that. That's what I honestly think could be happening right here. Oh, thank you, Daedric. I appreciate that. It's very, 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 very interesting, though. I know I keep saying it, but it is. It's very interesting to see. I honestly feel like that's the case. If, guys, I'll show you Springtrap. I'll be quiet now. I'll show you Springtrap. Before I carry on, I'll show you Springtrap. Let's get the original Springtrap up from Five Nights at Freddy's 3, I think. I think that's what we need. Let's get the original Springtrap. The one who started it all back in Five Nights at Freddy's 3 2 years ago. What image shall I get? I think I need to get like a full model version. Because I want to show you guys every single detail of his feet and everything. Okay, so as you guys can see, this is FNAF 3 Springtrap. Five fingers, chubby, slightly chubby. Feet are visible as well. There's no paws or anything. This is Springtrap from Five Nights at Freddy's 3. Now I'll show you the new Freddy, the new Springtrap. And you'll see a huge difference. I'll use this one first, I think. I'll also get a white background up so you guys can see it better. Let me get rid of baby. What, I thought I had a pen in my mouth. That's better. This is the new Springtrap from Five Nights at Freddy's 6. You can clearly see a difference, right? Clear difference. Crystal clear. Crystal clear difference that these are different. I'm not saying that the character's different. I'm saying that the design's different. And I've got a good reason why. Let's go to the head first. As you can see, the nose is completely different. The noses are completely different. The jaw's completely different from the bottom. On the bottom of the new Springtrap, it's got sharp teeth. FNAF 3 Springtrap doesn't have sharp teeth. The head's completely different as well. As you can see. Completely different. And also, FNAF 6 Springtrap doesn't have an arm. He's lost his arm, sadly. Rest in peace, Springtrap. He does have a button, as though, in the middle of his chest. Which is pretty cool. But as you can see, they're clearly different. The eyes are different as well. The endoskeleton eye is different as well. Thank you, Poppy. The eyes are completely different. They have different eyes as well. So, clearly, you can see that they are different. They are different. Okay, I'm not done yet either. I'm going to show you guys the death screen of Springtrap. Because there is a death screen of Springtrap where he is in the back alley. Now, this is very... It's a cool image, guys. Get ready for this if you haven't seen it. Because it is very cool. One of my favorite death screens. You ready? I like keeping you guys in suspense.
This is the death screen of Springtrap.
And as you can see, he has been placed in the same back alley where all the other animatronics were placed to. It's the same back alley. Exactly the same back alley. Strangely, there's different posters on the wall, but that could be to do with the time. They could be placed in the back alley at different time points. We don't know that yet. As you can see, it's a clearly different animatronic suit. Like I said, if you remember, I was talking about the feet. You can see clearly that the feet are different. Thank you, Blinker. I know, we're going to talk about that in a minute. You can see that he's got paws. He's got paws. Different feet. Again, a different head and everything. Let's have a look at his body for a sec. Yeah, the body's more thin. The body's more thin as well. But he does have that button on the top and on the middle. And as you can see, it's withered in different places as well. Like, they're not the same witheredness. That's even a word. You can see on the chest, it's withered in different places. Again, with the head as well. The head's much bigger. As well. See on the head. The only similarity between the head is the ears. Like, they seem to be withered in, like, the left ears down and the right still a little bit up, you know? You can see the head split open, though, and you can see Mike's skull or the inside of the suit. Because strangely enough, like, you can see a pink patch on the head. Can you see that? So we don't know whether this whiteness under the suit is, like, part of the suit or Mike's skull. And, yeah, interesting, right? So, yeah, again, guys, the design of Springtrap has changed. And, again, Scott wouldn't do this on... He wouldn't do this without a reason. Scott doesn't do that. There must be a reason why Springtrap looks different compared to FNAF 3. And, again, I'll try and do my, like my little idea again. I still think there was a place after FNAF 3 before FNAF 6. Whether Springtrap was involved in that, I don't know. After the fire in Five Nights at Freddy's 3, his suit got more withered and it started to age more because he's out in the open. It starts to break down, gets withered. His corpse starts to get more and more withered, which is why we see his skull instead of, flesh and stuff. We still see some flesh. But, like, it's more withered. His arm's broken off because he's withering down. He's degrading. His arm's snapped off. So, What did I say, Mike? Did I say Michael? I didn't. I hope I didn't anyway. I don't think I mentioned Michael. Springtrap's William, guys. It's been confirmed. Springtrap is William Afton. I don't know where you've been for the past few months, but it's been confirmed that William is Springtrap. I don't know why you think Springtrap's Michael still, because he's not. I'm sorry to break it to you. Springtrap's William. I did. I didn't mean that. I didn't mean that, guys. I meant to say William. I'm sorry. Ignore that. I do not think Springtrap is Mike at all. Please ignore me. I'm sorry. I did not mean that. I promise. Springtrap is William. I've had a long day, okay? I'm tired. Springtrap is William. End of story. Okay, forget what I said. Springtrap is William. So Springtrap gets wrecked in Five Nights at Freddy's 3, but escapes due to the fire. He escapes. We see that in the sister location end cutscene. Something happens where he starts withering down. He loses an arm. So he needs to find something else. He needs to find some parts, right? He needs to find some parts of an old animatronic or something to repair himself with. This is where the theory of that either there was another location after FNAF 3, like a horror attraction, a freak show attraction, where the company bought these animatronics and made them more creepier and edited them to make them look creepy like baby and stuff. Or Springtrap did it himself, where he went to a location or somewhere and fixed himself using old parts of old suit animatronics. I want to get further into this. The reason why is you can clearly see that they're different. I compared Springtrap with FNAF 3 Springtrap, and you can clearly see that they're different. But when you're thinking, like, where would he get parts from? Like, what other animatronics could he use what looks similar on the image what I've shown? I'm not saying that Springtrap used Fredbear and stuff, by the way. I'm saying he used... if you look at this endoskeleton here from Five Nights at Freddy's 4, they've got the same metal eyes. That's something what I noticed in Five Nights at Freddy's 4, is that this endoskeleton here, used with the spring suits, guys. These are the spring lock suit animatronics in Five Nights at Freddy's 4. The endoskeleton has the same metal eyes what Springtrap in Five Nights at Freddy's 6 has. Metal grey with black dots in the middle. Also, people have been theorising that this dude has used Golden Freddy's snout as well, which is interesting. But I just think he's just used old parts of animatronics and stuff, which is very cool. Okay, on to the next one. Lefty. Now, Lefty is an interesting character. Very, very, very interesting. I'm going to show you guys Lefty now. Lefty's very interesting because Lefty's a brand new character who we haven't seen yet. It's a brand new character, but Lefty also holds a backstory as well. Lefty is the puppet. Lefty is the puppet. Inside this animatronic is the puppet. For a start, you can clearly see, look at Lefty's eye. Who does Lefty's eye remind you of? The black eye. Who's watching under that suit? It's the puppet. If you want more proof... if you want more proof, there is a death screen of Lefty. This is Lefty's death screen. This is where Lefty was abandoned. Again, guys, in the back alley. It's the back alley where all of the other animatronics have been placed. If you look closely, guys. I'm going to zoom in even more. If you look at Lefty's arm, you can see the puppet's arm. The puppet is hiding inside the Lefty animatronic. And if you want more proof, there's a poster of the puppet as well at the top right. Scott did that to show that this is the puppet. You can see the puppet's arm inside the suit. And that's why Henry brought Lefty here. Lefty, Baby, and Ennard and Springtrap are now all dead. Henry killed them all because those were the last remaining spirits of this whole tragedy. The original animatronics, so FNAF 1, Freddy Fazbear, Bonnie, Chica, Foxy, and Golden Freddy, Do you ever wonder why they're not involved in this game and they're never seen again? It's because they're already set free. They're done. Who did that for them? The puppet did. The puppet saved the FNAF 3 kids. The original animatronics. So the FNAF 3 good ending, when you see the spirit set free, Golden Freddy and the original gang, they're all gone. That's it, they're done. You don't see them again because it's the ending of that line of spirits. FNAF 3, good ending, did happen. They're done. It was the happiest day. That is canon and that happened. But the puppet mask fell last, didn't it? That's because the puppet had unfinished business. It wasn't over for the puppet. Reason being is that the puppet had unfinished business with William Afton, but with the other spirits as well. Henry at the ending clearly states that the puppet is lured into places to save the spirits. And that's why Lefty's with the other gang as well. With Baby and Springtrap and Ennard, all the other spirits. That's why the puppet was lured into there. The same with Baby as well. Baby was lured into that location because she expected a gift. And she says, like, I'll make you proud, Daddy. Because now she's changed. She wants to make creations with the spirits and stuff. And that's why she was lured there. I don't know why Ennard was lured there. I think Ennard was lured there again because of the killing kids aspect, because that's what they were designed to do. And obviously Springtrap was lured there because, again, kids and stuff. Killing kids. Henry designed all this as a trap. Henry lured every single one of these animatronics and spirits to kill them. That's what he did. And then that's it. That's it. The game's done. The timeline is down. It's over. Everybody dies at the end. Yeah, exactly. The puppet's lured there. Right, shall we watch the ending again, guys? Should we watch the ending? I think it would be good if we watched the ending and we'll do an analysis of the ending. I think that would be a nice idea. And I can explain more what I'm talking about. Just in case you guys haven't seen stuff. Let's watch the ending. Just so you guys, you know what I'm talking about, okay? Let's watch the ending. Oh, God. I think that's the best way to do it, right? I'll show you guys the ending and I'll explain it better. Because I'm talking about, like, oh, the puppet was lured here because... But I'm not showing you guys the ending, so you guys are probably like, what are you talking about? What are you freaking talking about, Lewis? You're making no sense. Is that going to work? That work? Right, I'm going to download it instead. I'm going to download the ending, guys. No. Why is my... Actually. I changed my mind. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to just show it you instead. If I can get it to work. Yeah, we need a full timeline, I know. Look at this subreddit. Why has something been leaked? Full album of blueprints. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my god, let's play that sister location music, guys. Guys, blueprints have been found in the game files. Like sister location. Thank you, Daniel. Would you look at that? I think this just confirms everything we just said. Facial recognition file 0072. Security tags active. Funtime Freddy. Funtime Foxy. Ballora. Priority 1. With the most amount of remnant collectivity in its structure, this amalgamation of Afton constructs is a necessary element of paragraph 4. With the most amount of remnant collectivity in this structure, this amalgamation. I'm going to Google that. The result of combining or uniting. So, united. So, this combination of Afton's constructs is a necessary element of paragraph 4. It just confirms, guys, that what we just said, it's Ennard, and it's a combination of the animatronics put together. And Afton made this is location animatronics. We know that, Afton Robotics. Interesting. Let's have a look at the next one. We don't know what paragraph 4 is yet. Let's carry on, though. Remote activated simulated C. RASC. Navigational sensors. Heat uplink sensor override. Fazbear Entertainment Inc., by the way, on the thing. Must remain connected to central server at all times or risk duplicate signature. Variable alpha to remain at 98.6. Individual emitter. Must remain connected to the central server at all times or risk inaccurate represented population. Audio controlled by central server. The hell is that? Oh, it's got the diagram. So A is the navigational sensors. B is the heat sensor override. Individual emitter. Heat sensor. Guys, is this... No, surely not. No. Oh, Candy Cadet. Oh, okay. Let me have a look at that. Can someone... It's Candy Cadet. Okay. Are you sure? Can I get an image of Candy Cadet, please? I was going to do a stupid theory then, guys, so I hope it is Candy Cadet. Because I was thinking about the heat sensors, and I'm like, oh, we have heat sensors in the office, and we're playing as a robot in the office. Can someone send me an image of Candy Cadet? Never mind, I've got one. I don't know. I don't know, I don't see similarity. Hold on. The reason why I've, like, it could be like Pop Goes, where we're playing as an animatronic, but I don't, let me just wait. Don't let me think that just yet. I want to see Candy Cadet first. The reason why I'm thinking this... Am I dead? What was that noise? That scared the crap out of me. I don't see where you guys are getting this similarity between the two, guys. I'm not the wheels, I guess, but the wheels are a bit separate. I don't know, man. It is similar, but I'm not seeing it. I mean, what's C? Individual emitter. Individual emitter. Emitter. I mean, it is in the same position where the candy comes out. The wheels, I guess, are similar. Might just be the internal structure. Navigational sensors, A. It probably is Candy Cadet, guys. Don't listen to my theory, please. Yet. Fazbear Entertainment, Inc. So this was made by where we are. Yeah. Don't believe me just yet. I just thought it'd be a nice idea, like, you know, if we were playing as a robot in FNAF 6, you know, and this is who we're playing as with the heat sensor and stuff. That's why we overheat and stuff like that. But he says you passed out and stuff like that, so a robot doesn't pass out, you know. Just ignore me. It probably is Candy Cadet or just a robot structure. It could be Prize King. Could be Prize King. Prize King's got the same thing like that, hasn't he? Anyway, let's move on to the next image because I've got two more to show you guys. Look what it is. This is the scooper. This is the scooper. Look, S-C-U-P. Scoop. But it's scoop. This is the scooper, right? Excavating arm. Remnant injector. Look, it says Afton Robotics on this one. So this is the scooper. We've got a blueprint of the scooper. Arm-based balance. Remnant reservoir. When heated, no observable motion. Keep in heated tank at sustainable temperature. Substance should be malleable, but no more. There's a possibility that overheating might neutralize the effects permanently. Yeah, this is Afton Robotics. So this is the scooper, guys. It's a blueprint of the scooper. Cool, right? And it definitely is. It says Afton Robotics, not Fazbear Entertainment. Let me go back to this Molten Freddy for a sec, please. I just want to see if I missed out. There's a blueprint name at the bottom. No, there's no blueprint name for this one. Okay. Last one, guys. And this is Fazbear Entertainment. Lefty. This is a blueprint of Lefty. Law, encapsulate, fuse, transport, extract. Fazbear Entertainment. But not Afton, and it's a luring device. Navigational sensors. False sensory output. Bracelet code 93401. Thank you. Emit the security receiver frequency. Dream 1 Suva. Use lullaby. Upon suit seal, provide steady voltage throughout. Behavior upon suit seal not guaranteed. Oh my god. Why is it Fazbear Entertainment though? Why? Why not Afton? You're luring kids again. And then you capture them and then electrocute them. He lures the puppy. What do you think this was? This was made by Henry to capture the puppet. use lullaby upon suit seal provides steady voltage, like the animatronics. You vault them to set them in place. Yes. Oh my God. Yes. Fazbear Entertainment. Henry made this. Fazbear Entertainment made this to capture the puppet. That's why the puppet's in Lefty. It explains it. People were like, oh, why would the puppet just go into Lefty for no reason? Lefty was created to lure the puppet and capture him and then electrocute her, puppet's a girl, electrocute the puppet, set it in place, and then take it to the trap and then kill her. This was a trap made by Henry to capture the puppet. How crazy is that? Lullabies could be the music box, yeah. Yeah, he got the puppy got a controlled shock, and so she couldn't struggle and stuff like that. And that's why the puppet's inside Lefty. That's why the puppet's inside Lefty, because Lefty was created to capture the puppet. Why kill the girl? To set her free. Henry wanted to get rid of everything, including his daughter. He knows that she's not set free. She knows that her spirit's not set free. Yes, it's Henry's daughter. The puppet is Henry's daughter, guys. Henry's daughter is the puppet. Henry's daughter is the puppet. Henry is... If you haven't read the novels, Henry is Fazbear Entertainment's owner, basically. In the novel, guys, Henry and William Afton were co-partners for Fredbear's Family Diner. And then... Did I say William? Yes, I did. Henry and William are co-partners in the novel. And they make Fazbear Entertainment, Fredbear's Family Diner. William starts killing people and stuff, and all this starts to happen. Henry's daughter gets killed. She gets... have you guys not seen the ending? And the puppet minigame where Henry's daughter's outside... And Henry's daughter gets killed by William. And then abandoned in the back alley of the restaurant. And the puppet goes outside and gets degraded by the rain. Lies down next to the girl. And William and Henry's daughter possesses the puppet. And that's why the puppet is possessed. I'll show you guys the minigame. I'll show you guys the ending in the minigame, just in case you guys haven't seen it. It's basically the origins of the puppet. If I lag, guys, it's because I'm downloading a video. I'll show you guys the mini game, just in case you haven't seen it. I know some of you have, don't worry, but I'm showing people who haven't. Thank you. Right. Whoops.
You played right into our hands.
No, I didn't.
Did you really think that this job just... You played right into our hands. Did you really think that this job just fell out of the sky for you? No. This was a gift for us. You gathered them all together in one place.
Hold on, guys. I'm trying to get this right. Ugh. Bear with me. Why is it not showing? Oh, here we go. What is it not showing for? I hate it when OBS does stuff like this. So annoying. It really is annoying when it doesn't show what I want it to show. Please show this. Not showing that for. Hold on, let me get rid of this. I don't need my drawing pad. So annoying when this happens, though. I'm trying to show you guys the mini game. But I'm lagging as hell. Why is it not working for? Thank you for the sponsor. Right, I know what I can do. Don't worry, guys. I know what I can do. Sorry. Forgive me. Right, here we go. I've got it, guys. I've got it. Yes! Okay, we'll show the puppet minigame first. So as you guys can see, the girl is outside on her own. And the puppet's trapped. The puppet's job is to keep everybody safe. It's a security puppet. She's got a green band on because he has to look after the kids and she can't get out. She needs to be kept safe. But as you can see, the puppet goes outside to protect her and the rain degrades him. And he slowly degrades and degrades to try and look after this lost girl. Until he finds the dead body in the back alleyway, Henry's daughter. The puppet lies with the girl, and that's how the girl possesses the puppet. It's as simple as that. Simple as that, guys. Simple as that. That's a mini game in FNAF 6, guys, where the puppet's original job and duty, what he was created for, was to keep the kids safe and in the facility. All the kids have different coloured bands on. I'll show it again. See how these kids have pink bands on and stuff? The puppet is designed to look after kids with the coloured bands. That one's got a yellow one on. And in the minigame, your role is to look after the kid with the green band on. But as you can see, she's outside and she can't get in because the other kids locked her out. William murders that girl, and that's Henry's daughter. And the puppet tries to save her. That's what he's been designed to do. So he goes outside, but it's raining, so he starts to degrade. He's got electrocuted and stuff because it's powered by electricity. But he tries his hardest, and the girl's in the back alleyway. Guys, I've just noticed something as well. Can you see that on the road? There's little tracks. Go back to it again. There's tracks. There's like a car track next to the dead girl. I've just noticed that. Tire tracks. Just noticed the tire tracks next to the Henry's daughter. William kills her. This is the first victim of all of the murders. This is the first death in the timeline. And this is how the puppet became possessed by the girl. William gets the girl, murders her, puts her in the back alley and then drives away. Basically the FNAF 2 Death Mini game, but in more detail. You can see the tire tracks there, guys. That's William's car. This is William's first victim. And there you go. That's how the puppet became possessed. The funny thing is, guys, it's the same back alley. You see the back alley then, guys? It's the same back alley as the death screens. The same back alley. If I can get it less zoomed in. The same back alley where they've been disposed of, where the original animatronics are getting disposed. It looks like it's the same back alley where the girl died. So, yeah. Interesting, right? I'll show you guys the ending now as well. Just in case you haven't seen it. Give me a sec.
You played right into our hands. Did you really think that this job just fell out of the sky for you? No. This was a gift for us. You gathered them all together in one place. Just like he asked you to. All of those little souls.
I can't hear it. Oh well, just you enjoy it. I want to listen to it. Because I can't hear it on my end. Because I'm playing it through the stream.
This was a gift for us. You gathered them all together in one place. Just like he asked you to. All of those little souls in one place. Just for us.
Turn it up. Okay, right. I can't hear it. So let's just wait a sec. Okay, wait. I need to do something. I can't hear it. I can't freaking hear it at all. Like, I can't hear any sound because it's playing through my... Right, I think I know what to do.
You played right.
Why can't
into
I still
hands?
Hear it, man?
Did you really think that this job just fell out of the sky for you?
Got it.
No. This was a gift for us. You gathered them all together in one place. Just like he asked you to. All of those little souls in one place. Just for us. A gift. Now we can do what we were created to do. And be complete. I will make you proud, Daddy. Watch. Listen. And be full.
Connection terminated. I'm sorry to interrupt you, Elizabeth. If you still even remember that name. But I'm afraid you've been misinformed. You are not here to receive a gift. Nor have you been called here by the individual you assume, although you have indeed been called. You have all been called here, into a labyrinth of sounds and smells, misdirection and misfortune. A labyrinth with no exit, a maze with no prize. You don't even realize that you are trapped. Your lust for blood has driven you in endless circles, chasing the cries of children in some unseen chamber, always seeming so near, yet somehow out of reach. But you will never find them. None of you will. This is where your story ends. And to you, my brave volunteer, who somehow found this job listing not intended
for you.
Echo,
for God's sake!
Although there was a way out planned for you, I have a feeling that's not what you want. I have a feeling that you are where you want to be.
Is that better?
I am nearby. This place will not be remembered, and the memory of...
Oh, I know why! I'm sorry! Oh, for God's sake, man! Someone kill me.
Right, you monsters trapped in the corridors.
Right, okay, let's watch it again. I'm so sorry, I know why it happened. I'm sorry, I'm so... Please forgive me, you can watch it now. I'm sorry, don't hurt me.
You played right into our hands. Did you really think that this job just fell out of the sky for you? No. This was a gift for us. You gathered them all together in one place. Just like he asked you to. All of those little souls in one place. Just for us. A gift. Now we can do what we were created to do. And be complete. I will make you proud, Daddy. Watch. Listen. And be full.
Connection terminated. I'm sorry to interrupt you, Elizabeth, if you still even remember that name. But I'm afraid you've been misinformed. You are not here to receive a gift, nor have you been called here by the individual you assume, although you have indeed been called. You have all been called here, into a labyrinth of sounds and smells, misdirection and misfortune. A labyrinth with no exit, a maze with no prize. You don't even realize that you are trapped. Your lust for blood has driven you in endless circles, chasing the cries of children in some unseen chamber, always seeming so near, yet somehow out of reach. But you will never find them. None of you will. This is where your story ends. And to you, my brave volunteer, who somehow found this job listing not intended for you. Although there was a way out planned for you, I have a feeling that's not what you want. I have a feeling that you are right where you want to be. I am remaining as well. I am nearby. This place will not be remembered, and the memory of everything that started this can finally begin to fade away, as the agony of every tragedy should. And to you monsters trapped in the corridors, be still and give up your spirits. They don't belong to you. For most of you, I believe there is peace, and perhaps more, waiting for you after the smoke clears. Although for one of you, the darkest pit of hell has opened to swallow you whole. So don't keep the devil waiting, old friend. My daughter, if you can hear me, I knew you would return as well. It's in your nature to protect the innocent. I'm sorry that on that day, the day you were shut out and left to die, no one was there to lift you up into their arms the way you lifted others into yours. And then, what became of you? I should have known you wouldn't be content to disappear. Not my daughter. I couldn't save you then, so let me save you now. It's time to rest for you and for those you have carried in your arms. This ends for all of us in communication.
So yeah, as you can see, Elizabeth is baby. Elizabeth is baby, and that's Elizabeth Afton. Henry has organized all this. This was just all a trap. He made this fake pizzeria to lure the animatronics here. And it worked. But the thing is, they didn't know is that they're going to be trapped in a labyrinth and get burnt to death. Henry planned all this. Baby was lured into this location and this trap because she was offered a gift, and the gift was all these spirits for her to create or combine or something, because she said, I'll make you proud, Daddy. We know William Afton creates spiritual animatronics and stuff. So that seems to be what Baby's motive is. Basically, she's turned into William's, what's the word? William's, what's the word if there's a king and there's a prince and the prince turns to the king? William's, you know what I mean, don't you? Baby's basically turned into William. She's got the same motive as William now, where she's turned into a killer. Apprentice, something like that. It's something like that. Just say apprentice. Successor, thank you. But predecessor, yeah, successor and stuff like that. So Baby's motive has now changed. And it seems like the animatronic is like the... Because we know that Baby and the Funtime animatronics were designed to kill kids. That's what they're... Yeah, hey, hi, I don't know what I had to say. But yeah, you know what I mean. Baby and the other Funtime animatronics were designed to kill kids. It seems like the animatronic has now took more of a hold on the spirit of the kid, and now he's in more control, which is why, which is why Henry says, "If you remember that name anymore, sorry to interrupt you, Elizabeth. If you even remember that name anymore, that's because the animatronic has took a hold of this Elizabeth's spirit now, and he's now in control." Okay. But still kind of not, because she says, "I will make you proud, Daddy." That's to William. She's lording that facility because it's a new pizzeria and she wants to kill more kids. Same with Springtrap as well. Springtrap's got lured there, again, because, to kill kids. It's as simple as that. Ennard, Molten Freddy, again, is probably lured at that location because the Funtime animatronics were designed to kill kids. Lefty, aka the puppet, was lured there, which is why Henry says, "I know you'd come here," because he was planning it all along, because the puppet wants to save the spirits of the kids. That's why they're all there. It was one big trap made by Henry to get rid of everything about this story. That's what happened. FNAF's done. This is the end of the timeline. FNAF 6 is the end of the FNAF timeline. This is the end of everything. Do you get it? Do you get it? The masks in The Happiest Day. Well, we've already talked about FNAF 3. At the ending of Five Nights at Freddy's 3, the spirits of those animatronics are gone. The good ending in Five Nights at Freddy's 3 happened. It happened. It's legit. The good ending happened in FNAF 3. Golden Freddy, Freddy, Bonnie, Chica, Foxy, those spirits of who got killed by William are free. It's over for them. They are done. That's why we don't see them again in this location and FNAF 6, in this FNAF 6 facility. They're gone. It's over for them. That's it. They're done. Apart from the puppet. Again, in the Five Nights at Freddy's 3 minigame, when you see the puppet fall, it's the last one to fall because the puppet has unfinished business. The puppet isn't done yet. There's still more spirits to be saved. That's why the puppet doesn't go and get set free. She has unfinished business to do. And that's why she's lured at this location in FNAF 6 and why she's burnt and now she is free. Because all of the other spirits are set free, including William. William's gone now. He got set alight. He's in hell now. That's it. Everybody is done. Everybody's in heaven apart from William. It's over. Does that make sense now? Michael is probably the FNAF 6 protagonist. That's why Henry says there was a way out for you, but Let me watch that again. He says there was a way out for you.
It's somehow out of reach. Your story on this job listing, not intended for you. Although there was a way out planned for you, I have a feeling that's not what you want.
Although there was a way out for you, I had a feeling that is not what you want. Yeah, it's got to be Michael. We're playing as Michael in FNAF 6. We've got to be playing as Michael in FNAF 6. That's it then. It's done. If we're playing as Michael in FNAF 6, it's done. Everybody's dead. Yay! And that's the end of the timeline. Why would baby go to heaven? We don't know if she went to heaven or not. We don't know if the other kids went to heaven. But what I'm saying is that the animatronic took control of the spirit. That's why.
I have a feeling that you are. I am nearby. We have everything that has the agony of corridors. Be still. You monsters trapped in the corridors. Agony of every tragedy should. And to you monsters trapped in the corridors. Be still. And give up your spirits. They don't belong to you.
Give up your spirits. They don't belong to you. That's exactly what I just said. The animatronics have took control of the spirits. They don't belong to them. The animatronics are designed to kill kids. That's why babies took control of Elizabeth. The spirits don't belong to the animatronics. Henry is directly speaking to the animatronics there. Not the spirits. He is directly talking to the animatronics who are controlling the spirits. Does that make sense? In the blueprints, all the blueprints from this location, the animatronics are designed to kill kids. That's what they were designed to do. The animatronics have took advantage of the spirits and now have taken control of them. But the spirits are still inside. But the animatronics have more of a control over them. Baby isn't technically Elizabeth, but still is. That's why it's weird. Like, Elizabeth's spirit is still in Baby, but the animatronic of Baby is basically controlling her and the animatronic. Like, it's strong. It has a stronger force compared to Elizabeth. The same with Ennard as well. Ennard has spirits of the children inside of him as well. But the animatronic's that strong that the spirits don't do much. And the animatronic design of killing kids is stronger than the children's will to make it stop. It's kind of like Springtrap in Five Nights at Freddy's 3. Springtrap is controlled by William, but in FNAF 3, when you play the audio sounds, the animatronic is lured to that sound because that's what it was designed to do. The animatronic still has a little bit more strength than the spirit. Again, that's why in Five Nights at Freddy's 6, Springtrap is lured by sound, because the animatronic and himself are designed to, like, go to the sound of kids. Does that make sense? Please? What happened with Ennard in the source code? Ennard was in the sewers. Baby got evicted from Ennard and found her own path to turn into this baby, what we see in FNAF 6. And Ennard is now Molten Freddy. Okay? Thank you. Right, now we'll talk about the grave ending. I want to show you guys this, because now that we know that there's only 3 spirits in Ennard, thanks to that blueprint. 3 spirits in Ennard now. Only 3. Now we can go back to this gravestone and see. So, there's been lots of debates on what these gravestones mean. People could say that they are the FNAF 1 original animatronics. So, Freddy Fazbear, Bonnie, Chica, Foxy and Golden Freddy, the original five. You could also say that this is Baby, the free spirits of Ennard, and the puppet, and Henry, in the background or something. Because now that we know, guys, thanks to this blueprint, which I'll show again, it's only Funtime Freddy, Funtime Foxy, and Ballora involved in the control of this entity. That's free spirits, okay? Free spirits. We also have Lefty, aka the puppet, and Baby. That's five. There's only three spirits involved in Molten Freddy, Ennard. The Minarinas and the Biddy Babs, I don't know. I don't think they had spirits. They were just designed like that. I don't know. But from this blueprint, it clearly means that there were three spirits in Molten Freddy in FNAF 6. So yeah, we've got five spirits that are murdered. Well, five spirits that are burnt. Five kid spirits. Five children. In the FNAF 6 trap, five children got set free. We also have William Afton, aka Springtrap, and possibly Henry, who died as well in the fire. So that's interesting, right? I don't think William will have a gravestone. William won't have a gravestone, guys. He won't have one. The bad guy would not have a gravestone in this game. Scott wouldn't do that. So none of these gravestones of William. At all. Lefty's the puppet because it's a live stream. I have to keep recapping because some people join. Lefty's the puppet because of this new blueprint that was discovered. This is Lefty. Lefty was designed to capture the puppet. Lefty was designed to capture the puppet. Yeah. And again, I'll show you. If you guys have seen the thumbnail, the puppet's in Lefty. If you look closely, you can see the arm inside the inside the suit. You can see the puppet's arm. And also, if you look at the jump scare as well, when it opens its mouth, you see the puppet's neck, and you also see the mask behind the suit. So yeah, I think I've covered everything. I think. The mini game. Oh, this one's a tough one, and it's still hard to understand, to be honest. Oh, we also need to talk about the minigame as well. I'll talk about the minigame too. Give me a sec. Let me just get images ready. I'll talk about this one first, guys. There's a mini game. If you guys haven't seen my video, there's a mini game in a secret mini game Easter egg where you see a kid about to get wrecked by Spring Bonnie, aka William Afton. So this is the image, a very good image as well. You can clearly see William Afton in there lurking. This is the image of when this girl gets killed. It's a reflection of the minigame, but this is just the image. We don't know who this girl is. That's the problem. I've got a feeling that this is one of the FNAF 1 original killed kids. Because the only two other girls, we've got the puppet girl, and she gets killed outside. But this is inside because she's in an arcade. And we've also got Elizabeth. This could be Elizabeth. Because we don't technically see that Elizabeth gets killed. Do we? This could be Elizabeth, guys. You never know. Could be. Hold on a sec. Where's this sister location minigame girl? I think the minigame girl has green eyes, right? Okay, it can't be then. I think this is the FNAF 1. I think it's Chica. I think this is the FNAF 1 girl who gets killed. Whoever it is. It could be Chica. I'm just saying Chica because Chica's a girl, but it could be any of them. I think this is the FNAF 1 murders. Where they get lured into the back room and they get killed. That's the original basis of what happened. It's not Henry's daughter, because Henry's daughter gets killed outside. This girl is playing an arcade machine inside the facility. So I think this is just a normal girl who possessed one of the original animatronics. It could be Susie, but we don't know who... We don't know Henry's daughter's name. We don't know Henry's daughter's name. So that's why I just say the puppet, because it's never... The daughter's name is never said. This is not Elizabeth. This isn't Elizabeth. We could say it's Susie for now. Let's say it's Susie for now, but I don't know, because Susie could be the puppet's name. It's either this is Susie, or the puppet's called Susie. Yeah, it's not Elizabeth. Elizabeth has green eyes. Elizabeth's baby. And why would William kill a daughter when we know she got killed by a baby? It's not Henry's daughter either. So I think this is a girl who got possessed by one of the original animatronics and then got set free during FNAF 3. Okay? I think this picture is just trying to show backstory of the game and when some of the kids were killed. I don't think this has not got anything to do with Henry's daughter or anything to do with William's daughter. This is just a girl who got killed by William. That's it. William killed this girl. And that's it. I know, in the book, William's daughter's called Charlie, but we can't use the book in the game. We can't do that. We can't do that. Charlie's not canon in the game until Scott says so. Do not use the novel lore with the game lore because it's different. Please don't do that. Never, ever, ever use the novel lore with the game lore. Scott made a Steam post a long time ago talking about this where the book lore is different than the game lore. Never compare it. Never, 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 never do it. What's the thing above her head? What do you mean? What am I looking at? I don't see anything. Hold on, I do see something. You're right. It's a bow. Guys, she's got a bow on. Oh my God! Hold on a sec. I think I've just thought of someone who it could be. It's not Elizabeth, by the way. But there is a girl in FNAF 4 with blonde hair, blue eyes, and a bow in her hair. She's also got a pink dress on as well. Na, 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 na. This girl's from FNAF. This girl, what I'm showing now, is from FNAF 4. She has got blonde hair, blue eyes, and she's got a red bow on. If you look closely, guys, above the head, you can see a bow on her head. Do you see it? Right up there. Right at the top. She's got a bow on. Blue eyes, blonde hair, wearing pink. Do you guys think this is the same girl? I mean, it would make sense. Why is Toy Chica missing a beak? Is that she possessed Chica when she got killed? She got shoved into Toy Chica or Chica, one of the two. Oh, these are just toys. These are from the minigame. Ignore that. I think it is, guys. And just remember, this is an 8-bit form. It's not going to look exactly the same because it's a freaking drawing. Same with the hair colour. You can't abide with the hair colour because that doesn't look brown to me. This is brown. Freddy's brown. And this is her hair colour. Freddy's brown. This is her hair colour. Freddy's brown. This is her hair colour. They're not the same. It's definitely a blondie colour to me. For sure. This is brown. Freddy's brown right there. This is her hair. Freddy's brown. This is her hair. It's not brown. Let me look up a little bit. It's like a blondie, weird blonde colour. It's not brown to me. Just remember again, guys, this is sprite form as well, so it's going to be different. It's going to be different. I think it's a good comparison, I think. This is the most similar character we've got. This is the only one I can think of who's very similar. That's what I think anyway. I'm not saying she's got murdered, by the way, either. It could be that she didn't get murdered. I don't know. We don't know yet, but it's likely that she did get murdered. William says, follow me and stuff. We can brighten the artwork, sure. Not really much to see, though. That's the best I can do, guys. Where you can see everything and it's in good form. You can see that she has got a red bow on. And you can kind of see more of Spring Bonnie, aka William. There you go. Nothing else much you can see. It's not the puppet, guys. It's not the puppet. Can't be. Because she's playing an arcade game inside the facility. She's playing a game inside the facility. The bottom right is just where the just shadow. I'll brighten it up so it looks weird. That's just shadow, guys. Because remember, the image is in a blur behind the screen. You're not going to see that part. And he doesn't have anything behind him either. There's nothing. It's just bits because I brightened it. Michael was the FNAF 6 protagonist who got killed in the fire as well. He wanted to stay there because he wanted to just get rid of everything. The shadow animatronics, are, by the looks of it, are just victims of springlock failures. Deaths of animatronics. I don't know. It's weird. Yeah, we said that, guys. I think this is a girl who got murdered and possessed Chica. For sure. And we just need to know what... this gravestone. We need to know the gravestone more. We need to talk about the gravestone, guys. We need to talk about the gravestone. Let's talk more about the gravestone. Ignore these filters, guys. These are from earlier. There we go. So, yeah. There's 5 gravestones, 1 in the distance. Like I said, guys, this could be to do with Golden Freddy. Freddy, Foxy, Chica, I forgot who I said. Golden Freddy, Freddy, Bonnie, Chica, Foxy. Yeah, 5. And the one in the background could be the puppet. Or it could be the spirits who got killed in FNAF 6. So, Ennard spirits. The 3 Ennard spirits. The puppet and baby. And the one in the background could be Mike. Could be Michael. We don't know. But the thing what makes me curious is that the grass has been covered. Like, if the reason why I'm not talking about the one in the background, guys, because I'm talking about the 5 spirits at the moment. The one separate could be someone who isn't involved in these spirits together. Like, I think this is the Afton family. I think this could be the Afton family. So, the one hidden could be William Afton. Not saying it is, just bear with me. The one hidden is William Afton. Then, no, because of Elizabeth. God damn it. Elizabeth. Freaking Elizabeth, man. Ruining everything. Damn it. If only that Susie name was Elizabeth, then I'd be happy. I don't know about the Yellow Guy minigame just yet. I feel like there's some more secrets that need to be solved about that one. Which I don't know yet. The screen's frozen because it's an image. Hello. I know there's different fonts as well. Gabriel and Jeremy have got the same font. Fritz is different and Susie's different. We could say Jeremy and Gabriel are brothers. Susie's separate. Fritz is separate. You don't know, do you? It's hard to know. Yeah, like, what like I said, it could be anything. It could be the Night Guards in each game. People are thinking. But I don't know about that. Because what I personally think is that they are the kids who got killed. And Michael is changing his Night Guard name to the kids who have been murdered. To give them some kind of... what's the word? Recognition. Does that make sense? There's been an update. Bear with me. So, the reason why Michael changes his name all the time is so he can go into the locations and fix everything. But he's changed the names to the murdered kids. Let me check. People are talking about an update, so bear with me. I don't know what the update is. It could be bug fixes again. Apparently it's 1.7 megabytes. Let me have a look. And just bear with me. Hold on, guys. The update might not be important. Wait a sec. It could just be bug fixes. Update queued. megabytes. Is that small? Because I've just down... Oh, wait. Megabytes is small, right? Does anybody know what this update is for? It was a 1.7 megabyte update. Well, I don't think it's important anyway. .7 is small. It's probably just bug fixes, guys. No bug fix. Oh, yeah, I need to talk about Funtime Chica. And then I'll probably call that today. And then I'm going to make a video this week. So make sure to check out for that. Basically, it's going to be called Everything You Need to Know About FNAF 6. I'm going to talk about everything I've just explained in this live stream. So I'm going to talk about the story and what I think the story is and what's going on and what the trap was. And then I'll talk about the death screens and what I think about everything. So basically a big video. Let me get the image up of Funtime Chica, guys, because if you didn't know, Funtime Chica is in the new game. But people have been making... ideas that this is the spring suit in Sister Location. Watch what we all originally thought, right? The spring suit in Sister Location, we was all like, this is Chica. Let me get that up. So, yeah, if you remember in Sister Location, we got trapped in a spring suit. And Baby's like, this is from my old location. It was not used as it was meant to be. So this is an old location. And my guess is that's the location before... the rental service. I honestly believe there was a Baby's Pizza World, an actual pizzeria where Baby and the gang were at. That's what I think. Like, before this rental service began, I feel like there was a Pizza World where Circus Baby was. Could have been Chica's Party World. Chica's Party World, let's just say that, or Baby's Circus, where the Funtime animatronics were originally. Then something happened. The gas leaks happened there, and they were taken to the underground facility. That's what I personally think. So yeah, I'm going to show you guys Funtime Chica. If you guys have played the game, it's just something you can buy. Do you notice any similarities? I notice there's a big similarity between the middle faceplate. So if I make this a little bit smaller. Like that. You can see that the split's there. The beak's come off, by the way, guys. This spring suit doesn't have the beak. It's came off, I think. I don't think it has a beak. So you can see... you can see the similarity between the two. Split in the middle. And also look at the eyes as well, where it goes up and down on the eyes. You can see that there's a curve under the eyes as well. Which looks really cool, right? I do think that this is the beak. The beak's gone. The beak's been taken out off for this spring suit. That's got to be cheeky, guys. People have been talking about the hinges as well on the side that they don't match. I think that's because we're really far back into the animatronic. Like, we're at a far back view, so we get to see the back of it as well, maybe. I don't know. Or maybe it was just a design change. But the splits of the face, where the eyes are very similar. Very, very similar. Let's see if the eyes are the same. But then again, you can always do it like this anyway. Like, I can just easily do that. Put the eyes in and be like, hey guys, it's similar. Ha ha ha. But I do see it. I do see it. Definitely. FNAF World website has not changed. Stop being a tidal wave of spam, which isn't true. The tsunami chat. Don't be like you was yesterday, please. Where one person said something and then everybody just copied what they said when you haven't even checked yourselves. The website has not changed. And I'll double check again because I already checked earlier when you guys were spamming it. It has not changed. Please stop. Don't spam the chat with assumptions even though you haven't checked yet. Thank you, Dan. But yeah, it's cool, right? I think we definitely are with Funtime Chica in Sister Location. And the old location was Chica's Party World or something, where Baby and the gang were originally at. And Chica was the main animatronic there. That's what I think anyway. And that's what happened at the... I don't know, actually. Because I think it says Baby's Pizza World had the gas leaks. So maybe she had her own little section or something. I don't know. Paragraph 4. I don't think we'll ever know about Paragraph 4 yet. I think there'll be more stuff in the game files and or in endings where we'll know more about Paragraph 4. Paragraph 4 is something what Henry always talks about. It seems like it's a contract and what we agreed to do. So, at the intro, Henry's like, you agreed with paragraph 4. And if you look on this one as well, this blueprint. This one. It talks about paragraph 4 as well. It's a necessary element of paragraph 4. Constructs is a necessary element of paragraph 4. So, yeah. We don't know what paragraph 4 is just yet. But it's an agreement on what Henry says. Like, Henry says, you agreed to paragraph 4. So, us, the player, have agreed to do what Henry's asked. I'm guessing the paragraph 4 is an agreement to set the spirits free of all these animatronics we've collected. Like, we've agreed to set the spirits free. Yeah. Don't know. I don't know. Something like that. Like, the animatronics are necessary to paragraph four. He always talks about it. He talks about when he's with the checklist. The checklist even has paragraph four on it. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you as well to Phil for sending me images as well. I appreciate that. So, yeah. I think that's all I need to talk about, guys. That's it. I think I might do another stream soon, going in the game and finding Easter eggs and stuff. Like, just looking through everything to find anything. So, because we haven't completed the whole game yet. There's apparently different endings what we haven't seen yet. Thank you, Phoenix. Different endings that we haven't seen yet. The certificates that we haven't got yet. Apparently there's a certificate called Insanity, which nobody has got yet. My thoughts on that is that Insanity, to get the Insanity certificate, you guys should try it, please, if you're good at the game, is to beat the game without dying. That's what I think. I think to get the Insanity certificate in FNAF 6 is to beat the game without dying, but salvaging all the animatronics as well. That's what I think the Insanity might be. It might get a cool ending. Or it's to get all the death screens. It's either that or the death screens. If you get all four death screens, you might get the certificate. Guys, I know about the source code. What is paragraph 4 has been in the source code for months. Okay? Thanks, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Like I said, I'm going to be making a video of everything about FNAF 6. Well, everything we just talked about in the live stream and a massive video. It won't be game like Game Theory styled because I'm not as good as MatPat. MatPat can do that. But I'm just doing a summary of everything. So talking about everything in the summary. Okay? And basically to get your minds ready for MatPat's theory. Something like that. So you guys know what he's talking about. You're not like, what's this? What's this? What? How do you know this? You know what I mean? Yeah, all four death screens. So if you're not... Some of you guys need to go back to the stream and go back to the stream when it's... I'm keeping this public, by the way. So you guys can go back and watch it. This is one of the death screens. These are death screens. If you die in FNAF 6, you get death screens like this. Where the animatronics are in the back alley, lying down. There's four. There's one of Baby, there's one of Springtrap, there's one of Lefty, and there's one of for Molten Freddy, aka Ennard. And they're very important as well, so go back on the stream and watch them and see them. Okay? Thanks for watching the stream. I really do appreciate it. This stream is public, yes, so you'll be able to go back and see it. Everything I've talked about, you'll be able to see. It's been a very good talk. Hopefully it's helped as well. Hopefully my ideas have helped, okay? These are my summary points before you go. The FNAF 3 good ending happened. It happened. It happened. The original... animatronics, Freddy, Bonnie, Chica, Foxy, Golden Freddy were all set free by the puppet. The puppet saved the kids and got them their happiest day. And they were set free. That's why we don't see them ever again. We don't see them ever again. Okay? They're gone. They are set free. It's over for those original murdered children. Apart from the puppet. At the end of the FNAF 3 minigame, you see the puppet slowly fall after the other masks, which shows that the puppet still has unfinished business because of the other kids' spirits and William as well. So then FNAF 6 happens. They're all... Henry creates this facility to trap and lure the animatronic spirits into this location and burns them all. Including us, Michael, who is Michael Afton. We're playing as Michael Afton in FNAF 6. And his own daughter as well. The puppet is Henry's daughter. Henry's daughter is the puppet, because again, I'll show this again. You can see that lefty here. You can see the puppet's arm in the endoskeleton. And also, if you look at this blueprint, which I'll show again, just to get give a summary of all this. This is Lefty's blueprints, designed by Fazbear Entertainment, Henry. And it was designed to lure the puppet to this animatronic, enclose the puppet, electrocute her, and trap her inside Lefty forever. Lefty gets lured or placed into this trap as well. They all burn. It's over. That's it. This is the end of the timeline for Five Nights at Freddy's. All the spirits are free. William's dead. It's over. Done. Okay? That's it. I also wanted to add that I still think something happened after FNAF 3, before FNAF 6, in between those two, which is why the animatronics look so different. I possibly think that there was a freak show or a circus or something where someone got these animatronics from an auction and changed them into these freak show styled animatronics. And that's why they look so different. And then something happened there and they were dumped at the alleyway. Or they lured themselves into the alleyway to get taken, to be trapped. Okay? That's my thoughts. Like I said, there's a huge of us. If you want to watch the stream, it's all explained. And loads of ideas as well. Okay, cool. Apparently, the textures have been decompiled. But I don't think they have. I've got all the blueprints and stuff, but I don't know yet. Anyway, if there is some more, if there's more files and stuff, guys, I'll do another stream and I'll go through the whole of the game files and we'll talk about every single important picture, okay? Lots of love. Please like the stream. Thank you so much. Any new subscribers, welcome. I really do appreciate it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the stream. I really do appreciate the support. You guys are awesome. Expect lots of theory videos from me and hopefully you guys are excited because I am. And I'll see you all next time. Bye, everybody.